5 Ustespa, Omene One. Primeramente, saludos y respetos going out to everyone. Check this one out. Today I'm going to talk about 1999, the year, Haydock Junior High School location, Westside Hill Street, the city of Oxnard, 1999. Yes, of course, there was different factions. And back then, the way you should separate yourself is the Colonia boys, they were by themselves. They didn't like nobody. And then all the other little barrios were getting along back then. So for that reason, the derogatory term, the get-alongs. But anyways, I'm going to start off with the Loma boys. Loma boys had two foos. So they had some foo 5150. His name was Jared or Gerald. One or the other, Gerald. They call him 5150. He, from what I've heard, he ended up moving to Victorville or Victoria, somewhere over there. And he ended up starting on Loma Flats over there. And then I haven't really heard from him much in the past few years. So there was another one named Ariel. So Ariel, he was a down little fool, you know, down to get a mob, little criminal ass fool. And I've seen him get into a few fights. And then funny part of the story, right? Like, we were friends for about 2 years, almost 2 years. Just got out the gym, you know, so I'm kind of tired right now. So, one time we were inside his pad, right? He lived on Hill Street in the apartments, in the pink apartments. Back then they were pink. And Loma Flats had like a get together, or I don't know if it was a meeting, but there was like a good amount of fools right there, you know? A good issue of fools. And so he brings my bike to the pad, and he lets me out through the back window, you know? Because if I would have passed through there, they were going to hit me up. I was going to tell where I'm from, and it would have been all bad because, you know, we're rivals. So, you know, fast forward to the future, like 2001 or 2, he happens to, he happens to go to juvenile halls, right? And I'm right there chilling in juvenile halls with all the homies from different barrios that get along, you know? So nobody gets along with Loma. It don't matter who you are, you don't get along with Loma. So now he's from Loma, Ariel, and the staff, they don't know who to bring out for program. Like, program means like showers or your hour, because everybody's on lockdown or whatever, right? So the laundry boy, he tells the staff, well, you can put him with Rosas, which is myself, and they get along because they grew up together and they don't got pleito, you know? So they bring me out and I tell them, you know, like, hey fool, look, like, I'm not tripping on you fool, but anybody else comes from your hood, if I'm gonna take off on them. But you know, out of the friendship that we once had, homie, I'm not tripping on you, though. I already have a gang of enemies right here that I could take care of, you know what I mean? So I'm not gonna trip on you. If you wanna trip, that's on you. So he said he ain't tripping. He said he got a bunch of enemies too, right? So why fight each other? So all right, feed me. So we took a shower. Everybody tripped out that I didn't rush him, or that he didn't rush me. And so when it came down to go eat lunch, when it came time to go eat lunch, there was a vato, his last name was Andrade, and he claimed Southside Chiquis at the time, you know, so he was mad dogging and woo-de-woo, trying to get crazy, you know. I told Ariel, look, bro, I'm not gonna lie to you right here, like, you're gonna have to get down with somebody, bro, so just don't beat around the bush, just handle it, my boy, don't even trip, fool. So he said, I'm down to get a mob, I ain't even tripping, fool. I just didn't want to get down with you because you were my friend, you know. So whatever, you know, I said, all right, fool, feed me. So we're sitting together and we start eating, and that fool Andrade comes, sits down in front of him, and he hit him up. What's up, fool, where you from? I said, Ariel just got up and fucking served him like 3 times, excuse my language, boop boop boop. Served them like 3 times, and then they started getting down. And I personally believe that Ariel got the best of the other dude. But there was a lot of fools, you know, that didn't like Ariel due to the fact that his background and where he's from, whatnot. So they were cheering for the other fool. But from what I've seen with my own eyes, Ariel pretty much got him, you know. So that's the last time I ever seen or heard of Ariel. I don't know where he went. I don't know where he moved to. I don't know none of that. So then we have the Surtown boys. There was some dude named Katie Arcadio. He ended up not getting jumped in or nothing. There was a dude named Magic, but he started claiming in high school. So he was there with us in junior high, not claiming. Started claiming in high school, but that's why I bring him up. And then there was this dude named Bebito. He was like a hardcore kid, you know. He ended up messing up to the point where I had to rush him. You know, I'm not gonna smut him up on this little video or whatnot, you know, but he knows why. We ended up having like mild Plato, you know, little kid Plato, whatever. He got jumped into his hood, I got jumped into mine. You know, it was always like a little, there was always animosity between us. He ended up going to prison. I seen him in prison, and I attacked him because it's just a long story. You know, I don't wanna start smutting people up on here. So yeah, I attacked him, we got down, the homies got mad. It is what it is, you know? It is what it is. Last I heard, he ended up paroling and got deported. And he's somewhere in Mexico, bro. Maybe Nayarit. No, doing it up over there. I don't know exactly what he's doing, but he's probably making feria. I don't know. But that's where he ended up. And then we had my camarada Jera and little Shags. Jera moved on to be a regular guy. He didn't get jumped in, nothing. I got nothing but respect for that dude. Jera, aka El Bandolero, what's up, boy? So, furthermore, they had my homeboy Little Shags. And Little Shags, he ended up going to Nueva Vista Gateway Continuation Junior High School and high school. And at the young age of 14, 15, if I'm not mistaken, he robbed Kmart, came out with the money. They caught him, gave him juvenile life. He went to YA. He ended up slicing somebody in the face from another race. And he did his time, got out, went back for like 4 or 5. Got out, went back for another 4. And I'm pretty much, he's pretty much just kicking back right now. He's one of the few that got to get out and didn't really end up like the rest, you know. Dead or doing a double-digit sentence in the pinta, tú sabes, all that gets crucial, you know. So I mentioned the Loma boys, I mentioned the Surtown boys, I mentioned my little homies from El Rio, and with that being said, I think that's the only fools that were there from different barrios actively claiming, because there's fools that go to certain schools, they don't claim their barrio, and those are not cholos to me, you know. But with that being said, I'm gonna have to conclude with this video, and you guys have a good one. I will be back.